What does it mean to feel depressed? How does the feeling of depression come about? Depression can be, but is not limited to, severe feelings of helplessness, unhappiness, gloom, and sorrow. Depression can come from one's job, certain life issues at home with family, experiences from school, personal insecurities, and many other things. To tackle this problem, I will discuss a few common and most experienced causes of depression and explain how people can overcome those obstacles to better deal with issues in general. The first and most common cause of depression can arise from a person's life circumstances based on what our society deems is correct. People are put into classes or ranks which represents their status and value in our society. Most people tend to fall into the middle class section in their community and is living a financially stable life. It is true that we all have certain amounts of money, influence, etc. in the environment around us, but due to the class system and what it truly represents, it does cause depression in most normal people. People who are poor are looked at as less than people sometimes. Individuals who are of the same status or live in similar conditions are more likely to help others in their bracket more than someone else who they feel is beneath them. For example, rich people or the upper class normally do things for other rich people and look out for one another before they do anything for the poor. They are more likely to help another person who they feel has lived the same life or at least achieved success because it is assumed they attained it through good means. This goes for the middle class too. If you still do not see my point, look at it like this. If you played a sport, wouldn't you be more likely to help out another athlete quicker than someone who has no clue about sports in general? People naturally value some individuals more than others because they can relate to them. This truth will cause depression because this ideal can make anyone feel sad no matter who they are. If you're poor, you could be depressed about what society deems is a good life, which is why they shun you. If you're in the middle class, you can be depressed that you're not rich or in the upper class because you may be struggling to stay afloat, working hard hours. If you're wealthy and belong to the upper class, you can be depressed that there is nothing really special about your position besides what other people try to make it into, and that you supposedly have no life problems. So in my opinion, the solution to fixing this kind of depression is to not worry about other people's life circumstances in comparison to your own, but just make the best out of what you've been blessed with. The second and most common cause of depression comes from how people treat others. It is very easy to see the issues that come from the mistreatment of people in our society today. The school shootings are huge examples of this. People are being so mistreated or abused by their friends, family, and peers that they feel the need to lash out in some way. By treating others how you would like to be treated, this is something that would quickly fix these issues if most people actually cared to do that. The third and most common cause of depression, in my opinion, comes from social media. In this day and age, people are addicted to social media. Individuals do not realize how these networks have huge, persuasive, and subliminal messages shown all throughout them. Example, when it comes to lust and corruption of the human heart, social media allows people to sexualize everything. This is heavily promoted and taken advantage of by female dancers / sex video creators. It does not matter what site you're on, you will pretty much be bombarded with sexualized women on everything. They even allow it to be included in kids' cartoons. Snapchat memes, Instagram, Facebook, anime sites, etc. ads pop up constantly trying to entice the minds of everyone with naked women and even sexualizing cartoon images. Pornhub is one of the richest social media sites on the web. I'm almost certain they are behind all of these sexual ads, which makes people who do not think about these things become exposed to it. A quick realistic example of this is like when the Pilgrims exposed the Native Americans to a new disease that spread and nearly wiped them out. In some ways, this is very similar, but deals with a more mental and possibly physical aspect of an individual. Also, these types of companies know when kids hit puberty. This is the time they will market porno to them because of the physical changes they are going through. It's low-key an investment for the future as well, because these kids will easily become addicted to it at a young age, bringing it into their adulthood. But for argument's sake, let's just say they're not behind it. It doesn't change the fact that people and companies are promoting the exposure of sexual content that only corrupts the minds of everyone. People trapped in this will look at others as if they're foolish for not following suit with the false mindset and will tend to treat them badly. Sadly enough, some people become depressed from doing the right thing and staying away from this type of actions. Though people engaged into the porn are also depressed because they know deep down that this is not how people should live life, looking at others in such an adulterous way. However, from the world's point of view, they'd say it's okay because it's your decision. We need to realize that even if you make a choice and the choice is yours to make alone, that choice doesn't make it right in the grand scheme of things. Having sex of any kind, looking at things you shouldn't, and doing things that you know is wrong all come from the exposure to things that the world allows you to see. On top of this, social media can cause people to be jealous as well as make people be ungrateful for the things that they have in their life. People want to have more and more due to what they see other people have. You can't be unhappy about something you've never known about. Once we have been presented new things and new ways of life, people tend to jump on the bandwagon and not do what is right for their life or for what God says is right. Honestly, the only way to fight the depression caused from an addiction to all forms of social media is to just stay away from things that have subliminal messages and can corrupt you. In order for you to overcome depression, figure out what causes those issues in your life. If you're depressed from doing the right thing, just know you will be rewarded in heaven someday. If you're depressed from not knowing what to do in your life or feel that the world is misleading you down a false path, I personally would suggest just reading the Bible and gaining wisdom from it. Thank you guys for watching, and peace.